20 minutes now before 9 o'clock. Many people battling COVID-19 have ended up in the intensive care unit. Though they may have recovered from the coronavirus, there's a new concern now. Delirium, which is a sudden and serious change in brain function that results in confusion. And joining me now this morning is Dr. Babar Khan. He is a Regenstrief Institute research scientist, also a pulmonary specialist and a critical care physician. Doctor, thanks for being here to tell us about this. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing good. Thank you for having me here.
Oh, well, glad to have you chatting about this. So first of all, this is a different wrinkle than what we have really talked about. What is the concern that you have about this delirium, and is this something that you're seeing with growing occurrences?
Delirium is a condition of acute brain dysfunction characterized by confusion, which happens when you're admitted to the hospital. It can happen also outside the hospital, but more frequently, this episodes of confusion happens mostly in hospitalized patients, and especially in patients who are admitted to the intensive care unit. Now, if you're in the intensive care unit and if you're on a breathing machine and if you experience delirium, not only it increases your stay in the intensive care unit, it is also associated with other complications during your stay in the ICU that could include falls, pulling out your IV lines, and then pulling out your endotracheal tubes on the mechanical ventilation. Oh. And then when you are discharged, delirium is associated with a form of decreased brain function, a dementia-like syndrome, which we call ICU-acquired brain dysfunction, that can happen months after discharge from the ICU, and that can persist, at least from the evidence that we have, up to years after discharge from the intensive care unit. Now, in the context of COVID-19, it is so extremely important because patients with COVID-19, with their lungs principally affected, when they're in the intensive care unit, they are on the mechanical ventilation and they're experiencing delirium at a higher rate compared to the delirium rates that we were observing years before the COVID-19 pandemic hit us. So if you put it in perspective, larger number of COVID-19 patients in the ICU, a higher percentage of them developing delirium. So the potential for complications, not only during their hospital stay, but also after discharge from the hospital is huge.
I'm trying to understand how common this symptom is. It sounds like, based on your description there, that it can happen while a patient is hospitalized, or it can develop after somebody has been discharged from the hospital and then become an issue. How often is this actually happening in your experience?
So in the intensive care unit, if you are on a breathing machine or a mechanical ventilator, and if your age is above 60 years old, 60 to 65 years old, the chances of you developing delirium are close to around 70 to 80% in the intensive care unit. Now, from our older data at IU School of Medicine, the rates of delirium in all comers to the intensive care unit falls within the 30 to 40% range. With COVID-19, irrespective of your age, if you're in an intensive care unit, the rates of COVID-19 associated delirium are 70 to 80% in the intensive care unit.
Well, Dr. Khan, we are glad to know that you are working to reduce this risk and treat it. Thank you for your time and stay safe and have a great day.
Great. Thank you.
Okay. Appreciate it, sir.